My name is Thorsten Overgaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world taking photographs and teaching photography. Today I will talk about paper and sending letters. So I believe a renaissance is coming because that's how I feel. I've been very productive doing stuff recently with my photo archive, and I have two books coming out. The one is Why Do I Photograph? And the other one is the Leica Q2 book about the Leica Q2 and also the Leica Q2 monochrome. So when I travel around the world, I like to use notebooks. I really like paper. I have a little collection of notebooks here. I'll get back to notebooks because I just love to get different notebooks. Some things have to be very specific about them. And this is actually a notebook that you can buy from really soon. This one in different colors. And also this one is going to be one that you can get from me. But that's another story for another day. But I really like paper. I like to write stuff. I also have here, I buy more books than I can read. Sometimes I buy small ones and then bigger ones. And here I bought Tolstoy. That is like, I think it's 1600 or 1800 pages. So I definitely like paper. And one thing I did recently was that I had bookmarks made because I think it could be cool to give bookmarks away for free. Because if you get a bookmark, then you would have to use it in a notebook or in a book. So you can't use an iPhone, so you have to get a real book and put the bookmark in. So I had some of those made. And at different occasions I offered them on my Instagram and other places that I would send them for free. And it's really an interesting project because I actually have to handwrite the letters, and they cost a minor fortune to send any letter to anywhere in the world these days. But as part of it, people are very happy with this, and I'm very happy to give them away. Then I have a thing that when I travel, I like to send stuff. Here's actually some of the stuff I sent recently. I found this also paper, artist pad. It's really nice paper. You can see how thick it is. This is only 100 sheets. So these ones I've sent to people around the world, some of my friends. I thought they should have them. I also invested in really nice paper here and envelopes, handmade paper. I can send letters. So I've always kind of done that I would send letters and postcards to people around the world when I was traveling. And I'll send to anybody, like clients. I'll send to people who have been waited on me in a restaurant or in a hotel, or the hotel manager or the cleaning staff or staff in a Leica store somewhere in the world. So I did the same. Here I'm traveling. Somebody made a note or a comment in one of my videos. Said like, you have a lot of rooms in your house because there's a new desk in each video. It's kind of true, but it's different spaces around the world I travel to. So I've been in Denmark actually for a while. So when I was in Denmark, I would look for postcards, and I actually found some that is not that bad. They're kind of expensive. And this is from my hometown, Aarhus, like an old drawing. But I always wondered, even if I went to like a tourist place in Italy, that they didn't have any proper postcards. It's always like some old, small, ugly postcard that doesn't make any sense. So you're almost embarrassed to send them. So you really have, it's really hard to find a good postcard. I did find these, and I probably spent like $100, $200 in buying postcards. And stamps is also expensive. Like if you want to send a postcard or a small letter from Denmark to anywhere in the world, it's $6. And that's how it is in most countries these days. It's very expensive to send letters, especially international letters. But then I got a great idea. I thought, why don't I make, if I don't like the postcard I have, why don't I make my own? So I did that, and you can see this one I already wrote on them. I have like this is with Purple Ink, just for the fun of it. But for example, this one is from Skagen, when I was in Skagen. So I made a postcard from up there because they didn't have any proper postcards up there. So that's actually where I started. You could say you want to take photographs and you want to send it to people somewhere, maybe your mother or some friends, and explain, here I am. Is in Skagen, it's like there's no people here, and it's all yellow houses and it smells of fish, but you don't have any pictures to show it because nobody thought about taking pictures and making postcards of it. So I started doing that, and today I was just out in the printing facility, so I have like my first batch of postcards that I made for myself, by myself. I made 55 different versions, and I'm going to make more. I mean, one of the points I want to make is that you can make your own postcards. I really like the idea of postcards because nobody sends postcards. Nobody sends handwritten letters anymore. We send emails. And let me just tell a story. I went to Copenhagen to visit a friend and his wife and kids. So we've been friends for like a lot of years, and he's a graphic designer. So I went to them, and then they had made really nice dinner. They're good in the kitchen. They know how to do that stuff. But they also had made two desserts, and that was handmade cakes. One of them was handmade tiramisu, and the other one was handmade a Danish cake called Himbeersnitte. Nobody handmade stuff like that. But the wife said, nobody sends postcards anymore, but you do. And it's true, I always send them postcards, like not always, but I send them maybe every 6 months, I send them a postcard from somewhere in the world or a handwritten letter on thin paper. So she thought I deserved to have some really well-made desserts and food. So that's the goodwill you get. And I also have, particularly one hotel manager in the US that I sent him a letter. It's 3 years ago now, I sent him a handwritten letter from Rome or somewhere, Tokyo. And he still talks about that letter. And I mean, this is a person that gets hundreds of emails every day, and he has guests coming in and out of his hotel and all kinds of interesting events in his life. But he does remember that I sent him a handwritten letter. So that's why it's worth $6 in stamps and the time it takes. And it's something you can do when you anyways have a cup of coffee or taking a break, or you're reading a book and taking a break from reading a book, or maybe just you don't have to watch that much Netflix or something. Then you can write a letter. And so I thought, okay, I'm going to do my own postcards. And it was simply just a project that I did. And as I did it, it made me really happy that I actually have so many pictures in my archive. I have about, my archive is about 110,000, 120,000 pictures that are ready for use. So that means I took millions or whatever I took, but you know, you take 100 photos and maybe there's 10 or 20 of them that you like, and sometimes there's one in between that is like magic. But you could say 10, 20 photos out of 100 in New York is 10, 20 photos. So those I finalize editing, sometimes in color and black and white, and they go in the archive with keywords and everything, and they're ready for use. So that's how I make my articles on my website. I don't go out and take the photos from, I just pull them from my archive. And anything I do, I can just pull pictures from the archive. If you read my books, you will see that there's a lot of pictures in my books, and they're not necessarily taken for that book. So it's pictures also pulled from the archive that they make sense. And often my pictures have like some sort of atmosphere. It's not like, this is not just a picture from Skagen. It also had an atmosphere that is, you could say, it's very me. So you could say, in that sense, I make the postcard I would like to buy, so that makes totally sense. Why would I make something that I wouldn't like, you know? So that's what I did, and it's actually, I also made one just for fun here, always wear a camera, but that's probably the most boring postcard. It's not actually a postcard. Maybe I could make it in some nice paper or something so it was interesting, or silver, but as it is here, it's just not interesting. But I was really amazed, the pictures I have in the archive, how well some of them work for postcards. And yeah, I wanted to do my own postcards, so, but I also thought, how can this be used? Well, it can be used in the way that, for example, there's a couple of hotels I stay in Tokyo, and they don't have postcards. And then you can go to some store, but usually they don't have really good postcards, you know. And for example, here in Denmark, I went to look at postcards. They have all these cheesy postcards with cheesy jokes or happy something, or, you know, whatever. It's not aesthetic. It's not something you want to send to somebody. It doesn't. It's just not what you want. You want, you sit in Rome and you want to take a bit of Rome and send it to your friend and say, hey, this is beautiful and I'm doing well and I was thinking of you. That's basically the message of a postcard. So I have a whole concept here. You can see I even have a display here. So what I did is that I said, okay, I'm going to do here, I'll take out all of them because this is different packages and you can actually buy them on my website also. So I have here like mixed Paris, and this photo is one that I liked it before, but when I see it on a postcard, it's just, it's almost like, I don't know, a blue painting or something. It's really a nice card. And then I have here a package of Denmark. So generally there's like eight postcards, so you can buy like a pack of eight mixed postcards from Denmark or just mixed, or there's three or four different ones from Paris. I have a lot from Paris. This is New York. There's more Denmark here. There's one more Paris. Here's Berlin. And here's another New York. And here's one that is just about love. So it's actually not from a city, it's just like for the season of year, if the message is, I just want to send a heart or I want to send two people kissing, I can do that. And of course it have a nice space on the back so you can write on it. That's very important for a postcard. I mean, I bought postcards that when you write on them, the ink actually doesn't stink or stick. So that's of course not a great postcard. So the postcard should also be nice to write and it should be nice to receive. And I like this size, I don't like small postcards. I mean, it basically costs the same to send a small as a large postcard. So I made them large. And the great thing about this is like that these you could even just, you can just have them hanging. And the great thing is also you send it to somebody, they're gonna probably put it on the fridge or the wall or something. So in a way, I learned a lot from doing this postcard so far. I'm only like just begun on it, but you could say that as a photographer, you dream of that you make a big print and you sign it and somebody pays thousands of dollars for it and they put it on the wall, and that's great. But in a way, if you have somebody they send a postcard, then you look at the postcard and you remember you sent it, and the people who get it, they're gonna hang it on the fridge or the wall or somewhere. And it's gonna hang there for years. And it's more likely that somebody actually noticed this on the fridge or on the wall in the office than it is that they look at what is hanging on the wall. It's, you actually don't see very often what's hanging on the walls. It's just something is hanging on the wall. So in that way, it's great communication. And you could say a lot of the photographs I take because I wanna make something that is beautiful. I wanna make something that makes you feel good. Which is hard to describe what in words, so you can say that's great, it's pictures, so I don't have to express what it is I want to express. I can just take a photo and then people can look at it and they can feel good about it. And then as I did this, I thought, wow, I can sell it on my website, but I have to sell eight or more at a time because shipping them, sending them in an envelope is like quite expensive. So if you just buy one card, it's like it's the poster is going to be more than the card. So that's why I made packages of this, and you, there's a link below the video. You can see there's like go look. There's like big packages and small packages, whatever. And one of the things I also have is like no. So some of the hotels you can see here made some postcards here, and they actually have a logo here. They have here usually it says what it is or where it is and so on. Sometimes there's a history, like this is a history, this is an elephant in the old Carlsberg factory in Copenhagen. So there's a hotel next to this that I stayed in. So I made postcards for them. So they have a little logo here, and then you buy the card in the hotel and you can send it to people. And this is from year 1802. Actually, I'm not sure about that. It's 1901. That's what it is. So there's four big elephants made there, and they're actually named after the founder of Carlsberg beer. His four kids that didn't survive. He had nine kids, so four of them didn't survive. So he had four huge elephants made. Doesn't matter. It's just a nice picture. But it does actually say on the backside the year and where it is. So you could say you see this, oh, I want to go there, and then it says this is where you go. So these have logos for hotels, and that means that you go into a hotel and then you can buy a photo, not a photo, you can buy a postcard and you can send it and say, hey, I'm here, like this is Hotel Royal in Aarhus, Denmark. Here's like the Crown Prince and the Crown Princess with the four kids. A photo I took, I think it's with the M9, so it's like 10, 11 years ago. So that's like a family photo from outside the palace. And you can say this could be fun if you can buy this in a hotel in Denmark or in Copenhagen, and you can send it to your friends in back in Australia. Say, oh, there's Crown Princess Mary. She's one of ours, you know, or just, it's just cool that there's like royals, you know, nobody wants to send a postcard of the prime minister or something, you know, it's like royal is special. So, so a lot of different postcards, and it's really, really, really fun to make. And it's kind of ridiculous that you have this ideal of one is like, you know, I'm going to make a print and I'm going to sell it for $8,000 and it's very limited and signed. And then I actually get more of a kick out of making postcards that's not signed and cost much less. And the thing you can learn from this also is the thing that I always say is like that the business model of being a photographer will change all the time. So the important thing is that you take photographs. One thing is you should take the photograph that you like to take so you have fun with it. It's not fun to take pictures for others that you actually don't like to take. So you should have a style and a business model where you take the photos that you like to take. You can say, I do that because I travel around the world, I do workshops, I write books, so I get to take the photos that I want to take with the equipment I want to use. And I just stack them up in the archive, and I know that 10 years ago, the business model was that I could sell those photos to magazines and picture agency, and I would make money that way. Then the prices went down on that, and that whole market is just like, it's not worth spending time on, so I don't have any contracts with any picture agencies or any newspapers anymore. But I still take the photos. Then I can use the photos in galleries, I use them in my own books, I use them on my website, and I know that as long as I create content, content is always going to be valuable. Nobody can make a newspaper or a magazine or an exhibition or even postcards without content. So that's why content is always going to be valuable. I used to say that, I don't know, maybe in 10 or 20 years, the way a photographer makes money is that you sell pictures in your archive. You actually don't sell them, but you sell the rights to use them. But it could be that you go on your device at that time in 10 or 20 years and you buy a package of pictures as screensavers. And then you pay 1 cent for that. But that's fine. If 100,000 people or 10 million people buy your package with photos as screensavers for 1 cent, you'll make good money. And then they're going to buy more when they get tired of looking at those ones, you know. So the important thing is content. And you can look at, well, you can look at books. If you take a writer like Hemingway, he's still on the top 10 bestseller list on Amazon for a book he wrote 70 years ago, basically. So that's a good book. So it's, of course, it still sells. So things change, the business model changes, but something you make that makes sense, is valuable, pretty, or whatever it is still going to be a great business. And I think that's basically all I had to say today. If you do have a hotel or a cafe or a gallery or something somewhere in the world, then send me an email and then get like a package of postcards you can put in your store or your hotel, and you sell it and you make money and you pay me some of the money, and then everybody's happy and somebody get a handwritten postcard, and that's like even better than anything else. That's all I had to say today. As usual, if you go below the video, there's a link to where you can get a free ebook if you sign up for my mailing list. And as of course, there's also a link to the postcards here. And when I get into my notebooks, I'll do a video separately just about the notebooks that we're doing. And I'll also put that link underneath here when it's ready, because they're not ready for international shipping yet. They can only be shipped in Scandinavia, so they're made in Denmark. So that will be later. But that's all I had to say. Thank you for watching. And remember, always wear a camera. Thank you. So let me just point out how great and simple this is. I mean, you probably remember you have seen launches of new iPhones, and usually they have like 10 or 20 new emojis, and they can explode and implode and move around, and it's like the big thing. This is actually bigger. This is like something that went more than 100 years of thinking, design, testing, and prototyping into making a piece of paper, a postcard like this. So one thing is it's actually made of paper, and it's like it has a thickness, so it's nice to send, and it's nice to write on. It has a very nice surface here, and you can't cut yourself on it. Nobody can get hurt by this. It's actually organic material. It comes from wood. If you don't have anything else to do, you can clean your nails with it, and you can also make paper flowers and stuff out of it. But in this context, the great thing is that here, this one says that it's New York, so this is where we are, and this is a dog park. There's four dogs running around. It's very cute, and it also have my name on it down here. And this size, it's not glossy, but it's a little bit silky, so the picture looks nice. And on the back, it has this raw format here, so you can write on it, and also you can make drawings on it. You can even buy stickers, like emoji, and stick onto it. And here it has four lines. You can write an address here, and has space up here for a stamp. And then you can write on it this way, or that way. Over here you can write a message. You can write the date and, "Hello, Mommy, I just wanted to say hello." And you can make a big, nice signature and a little sunshine and make drawings of small houses. You can basically do anything you want on this. And it's something that people can hang on the wall when they get it, or they can even use it as a bookmark. There's many things, but this is like amazing. A lot of work went into this, more than 100 years of thinking and prototyping and testing of this. So it's really well tested, and it's very simple. And yeah, that's quite amazing.